Good evening, good afternoon, good morning. This is Haijin Lee with an evening update for Bitcoin. So we left off the midday update. As you see here, I had posted an update on the fractal of this bearish flag. Initially went down, now it's come above it and back within the channel. So let's get rid of some of these labels so that we can have a clearer picture. The price bars. Okay. Let's move all the labels to the right. I want to first begin with as to whether you might be able to see a pattern. And the pattern is, so let's draw some lines. So if I draw a line here, this is a bit of a slanted line. And the pattern that I see here is the left shoulder, left shoulder head, and then the right shoulder is forming now. If I draw freehand and now look like this, let's say. Now we'll label this as an LS, the left shoulder. And then we'll label this as the RS. And I'll label this the H, the head. Like so. And that means this left shoulder, the head, and the right shoulder. This is a head and shoulders top. It has bearish implications. And one way to confirm this is to look at the volume. You probably saw me peeking at the volume just earlier. The volume has left shoulder. The head is much higher than the shoulder. And then we should get a right shoulder on the volume as well. So the volume, at least from a pattern perspective, it should at least be some kind of a reflection. And that would give you additional solid confirmation. Now, you might want to say, well, what about this one, Haijin? I kind of explained that this morning, but let me just go through it again because I think you might think of contrasting example. So let's say I draw a line here. I make this blue. And then I said, oh, here's the left shoulder, here's the head, and here's the right shoulder. But if you look at the volume doesn't necessarily reflect. In fact, the volume of the head is like less than the shoulders. And that's one indication that you could have seen ahead of time and clearly failed. It was invalid. the volume in this case comes into play pretty significantly. If you want to go very strictly on the rules, you don't act on the head and shoulders until you get the volume pattern reflection as well. Just like here. Let's get rid of the volume since we've seen it now. For this side, I want to measure the minimum travel, the minimum price travel for this pattern, the climb. I'm going to draw a line from the peak of the head price straight down to the neckline. Okay. Copy that. All right. Next to it. Above it. And it comes down to 61.69. That is the price target for this head and shoulders pattern. And I think this is why one of the reasons why combining chart pattern recognition is extremely helpful to combine it with Elliott Reed analysis. So now we know that the minimum travel is going to be at around, let's make it even at 6150. Okay, so let's clear this up a little bit. You know there's a head and shoulders here now. And we move these lines, we're going to go back to our Elliott Reed. What we are saying is that here we are getting an A, B, C expanded flat. Where A is here, 1, 2, 3, B, 1, 2, 3, and the peak of the B has its here the party top. I think we want to know 1. Or 5, 5, 3. Clearly exceeding in a spiky format, but it really doesn't matter how it exceeds it. So we have A, B, and then we're going to work on C now. Now, I think what we are seeing here is 1, 2, 1, 2. It's what I call a nested 1, 2. Look like this from a count perspective. This. This aside. So if this head and shoulders call is correct, but first of all, this head and shoulder, the right shoulder has to complete. It has not yet completed. Okay? We're going to first see that as a development. So what am I doing? I am forward discerning this head and shoulders pattern top. I'm not calling this a top. Just the name of the pattern is that it's called the head and shoulders top. So I'm not calling the top. So I think we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this 5 ends now at 6150-ish. And what I meant by the earlier 1, 2, 1, 2 nested was I have 1, 2 here, and then I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. some waves. Maybe one. ABC 2 is being completed now. 3, 4, 5. I've just labeled the subways of wave 3 of C. Cycles. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And what we're saying is wave 3 is subdivided as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to move this sideways a little bit. I want to go high resolution. Just zoom in. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just showing the subwaves of this to show how it is. I have 1, 2, now I'm going to get 1, 2. So we look like this. One, two, three, four, five. That's the subways of one. And then I'm going to get A, B, and one more higher, C. One, two. These five ways become subways of 1 of 3, 2 of 3. That's how it subdivides from A to B. I see it. This 2 actually should be right here. Having shown that, we can now move these subways back. And so in this count, the ABC, the C goes, is projected to go lower than what I had thought, at 6,600 to 6,800. In this case, it goes to 6,150. So in order to have this happen, we need to have the right shoulder complete on the head and shoulders pattern. Let's see if it does, because if it goes to 2, and then it goes down to 3, it should complete. It should complete. There are other alternate possible counts. And one is that this wasn't the peak of 3, but you can move the peak of 3 over here. 3, 4, 5. And now you're starting the correction. But the destination will be about the same. Just the label will be different. The other possibility that I want to point out, and this is close to probable, but not my primary count, is A, B, C. Now you've got to remember that for an expanded flat, we have the condition of A, and the condition of B being higher than the prior peak, and the condition of C is that it only has to be lower than the bottom of A. So the condition of C could be A, B, A, B, C. And only slightly lower than A. And from here, you can just impulse up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from here. So this is my secondary count. I think this is close to being probable. Because the condition of an expanded flat is that the C only need be below A. And let's put it at 67, 6800 or anything below, let's say 6909 would meet the criteria that C wave is lower than A, and therefore expanded flat correction can be considered complete. And I have been thinking about this throughout the day. I almost made it my primary count, but given that if this head and shoulders was complete, and given that the volume so well could be matching it, I didn't make it a primary count. This is my secondary count, and instead, my primary count remains like this. This is my primary count on ABC. Expanded flat. And so let's see what happens to the overnight pricing. It may go higher. It may go just a little bit higher. And then it should start. If wave 1 of 3, 2 of 3 is done, then wave 3 should start begin earnestly. Because whether in the cryptos or in equities, wave 3 is still very energetic. And since this is a downward wave 3, we should see a good amount of energy pulling it down, and pulling it down hard. And it could morph into something else. My third count, as I showed you, was 3 is here, and now we're just beginning the correction. That is another possibility. Not yet, probably. But in a way, it's just different symbols pointing to the varying level of lower destination on the correction side. But we're still going to go from here and. A good number of you have been asking in the comments, well, what happens to the altcoins after Bitcoin finishes correcting and starts rising again? Is that going to kind of depress the altcoins? I don't know. But I think, given how bullish Cup and Handle, downward point in symmetrical triangles, jaws of wealth patterns, and uniformly bullish, ready to break out type of patterns across the cryptosphere. I think what might happen is once Bitcoin bottoms and starts rising, both Bitcoin and the altcoin will be in phase. And they could all rise in that same trend. That's what I would like to see. I've seen that before. I have seen when altcoins rise with Bitcoin. They are not completely inversely correlated. Only on a very temporary basis. Like you saw today when Bitcoin was correcting, all of the altcoins were melting up. Now once, and that may continue, let's say, if Bitcoin starts continuing to putting in lower lows in this correction. And when it turns, when the correction bottoms and the Bitcoin price starts rising, what I'm saying is that it would be ideal to see both Bitcoins and altcoins in things. And I think they will. Even if Bitcoin does ABC, just barely below the A, but still enough to put in a C wave and starts counting from here upwards, even then I think altcoins would be in phase with Bitcoin. So, let's see what happens. Nothing ever goes exactly to the objective price pathway. The details of how the pathway meets the details of the pathway that we laid out, that's not what's important. The accuracy of your plan is not that important. What is important? The direction of the price. I think the overall trend at the point is up. And soon, the overall trend of these patterns are going to be up. The Charles of Wealth pattern. And soon, the overall patterns of these cup and handles of steam for Zen is already progressed. This is Zen. Look what happened to Zen. Same thing's going to happen to steam. It's just a matter of if, but not a matter of if, but rather when. So it's a matter of time. So here's library coin. I mean, just beautiful, foolish looking pattern. This is why this is going to go up whether Bitcoin goes down or up. Once this starts, steam will go up whether Bitcoin goes up or down. Same thing with Stratus, this one. I can give you a whole boatload of more with this type of cupping handle patterns, and this is showing you what could happen. Zen of Wealth. We saw it doing exactly this horizontal channeling as you see here. And this here is really no different. It's cup and handle. And just like you can see, yeah, as well. Look at the uniformity of all of these patterns. Whether Bitcoin goes up or down, once this breakout happens, this is going to go up. Same thing here. Same thing with IOTA. IOTA. Once the breakout happens, it's going to go up. Whether Bitcoin is going to correct or go up with it. And that's what I'm trying to convey here, that after the correction is done, given all the patterns I just showed you, whether Bitcoin goes down or up, it's not going to almost matter because these, once they take out, they're going to go up. Whether Bitcoin is in a down correction or whether Bitcoin is in up trend of its price. I hope that makes sense. Because that means they will be non-phasic and phasic in phase. That's all. It's very simple. From a conceptual point of view now, whether that will actually happen or not, there is no assurances. There can never be any guarantees.
Why?
Technical analysis is nothing but identifying as many of the possibilities, narrowing it down to a good number of top pick probabilities, and then selecting your primary, secondary, and tertiary counts for price pathway probability. And I've already taken you through that here, earlier. I've given these patterns and the uniformity and the very high similarity index. They are all bullish, downward pointing for the most part. And when these break out, it will be a sight to behold. What you saw today was a melt of the off point. It was nothing. It was nothing compared to what you will see based on the patterns that I'm seeing right now. How I combine the pattern with the AUD can be quite powerful. Same thing here. This is giving you a preview of real effect preview is happening. Same thing will happen here. Here and here. Here, 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 and here. And it'll happen whether Bitcoin is in a downtrend or on a correction or an uptrend. It will be different, of course, if Bitcoin starts collapsing. If it goes below 5,000, mid 5,500, that's different. That will be a different skill to look at, a different count to reassess. I don't think that will be on the top of my probable list. Always remember that possibility and probability are not the same. Over the past week, I saw a few analysts, well-known analysts. Oh, I'm going to call the top. This is the top. I'm going to call the top. And too many times, people make the mistake of the top as an event. A top is not an event. It is a process. Topping is a process. It's not an event. That's a very, very important thing to understand. Just because it picked up here, it doesn't mean you call this a top. Topping is a process. It involves sentiment. It involves price action. It involves pattern, most definitely pattern in price, time, and in my analysis, it involves Elliott waves, the ebbs and flow of price, which is a reflection of sentiment. And if you commingle all of that in a cocktail of a process, that is what will be what I mean by topping in your process and not an effect. You can't say, oh, that's a top, everybody get down. No, it doesn't work that way. It always becomes and starts very gradually. And quite often still, because of that, it surprises many people after the top is actually put in. Most miss it. Okay, so I hope this has been helpful. Let's see how the overnight price action carries. And I'll talk to you in the morning. Now, I have noticed that I am getting now more upvotes, tons of comments. And I'm spending a lot of. I also put the videos on YouTube. And the comments on YouTube as well. I'm trying to see if I can help people there. And if I, for some reason, miss your comment, please don't be afraid to post it again. I'll get to it. But I am very, very grateful for the upvotes, you have been giving me. I'm sending thank you notes, a roll-to-roll message to as many of the uploads that I can see, especially the new ones. But they are the ones who I hope can also benefit from the blogs that I put out. And the high-value uploaders, I am very grateful for your time and attention, and I'm happy that my blog must be helping you, because I'm pretty sure you won't upload any blog that hurt you. So, again, thank you very much. Talk to you in the morning.